I'm Fumi Olopade from the University of Chicago. AACR fellows can mentor the next generation of scientists. And so I feel really honored to have been elected by my peers and to have had that honor bestowed on me the same year as my mentor who brought me to the first AACR meeting. As a fellow of the academy, my job is to let the next generation continue to feel the enthusiasm, continue to be optimistic. We have to do more with less, and that's really what brings the innovation that we're all gonna need to continue to advance the best science. In the era of precision medicine, I'm excited that oncologists like me will treat each person as an individual and would try to find the right drug for the right patient at the right time. If we're able to do that at scale, which is what I'm hoping that all the scientific advances will lead us to, then we will actually be able to eliminate some of the disparities that we have in health outcomes. Now we know breast cancer is not one disease. We know that we have to know the target before we treat the cancer. And then what's been exciting for me is that we know that your genes actually can determine the type of breast cancer that you get. We know, for example, that women who have a BRCA1 mutation get one of the most aggressive types of breast cancer. And the FDA approved a whole new drug class targeting women with BRCA1 mutation. And all that scientific advance happened in the last decade. So I'm very optimistic about the next decade. The decade of precision medicine will help us study diverse populations and then develop new ways to treat cancer and prevent cancer. But the cures of tomorrow are in laboratory petri dishes today. That's sort of how I look at it. Discoveries come in many different ways. Sometimes it's serendipity that gets us there. And it's really important for scientists to be creative, to be totally wild in their ideas, and then to be able to test it. In fact, when you have the freedom to be able to do that, that's when we've had the best ideas that actually come to benefit patients. The AACR has really been a really quite distinct organization that supports the best scientists. It really impacts the careers of young scientists. It provides a nurturing environment for them, and it helps them succeed in a competitive world of peer review funding. The other thing that the AACR has done incredibly well is to have a women in cancer research and a minority in cancer research focus. They were also, of course, the first to advance the science of health disparities. And I think as an organization, they really looked at what are the important scientific areas of investigation for our times. And then they bring membership to rally around that. And that will make AACR continue to be the leading organization in cancer research.